Hello everyone, how's it going? Trevor Master here, and welcome back to League of Legends round number 5 and number 6 here. And yes, it was an interesting one in this one. And as you guys can see, I've started up a lot higher than I normally do. Because I got into a cart in this first race in round 5 where it was actually a really quick cart. So I was actually starting the fastest cart. I started on pole for the rental cart class, and I'm in the rental heavy league. And as I said before, if you guys want to know more info about like how the classes are divvied up, feel free to go back to the first round of the championship, how everything goes, and you guys were just messing about on the grid. We do our normal banter in the start. But anyways, I wanted to first actually show you here. This was actually an interesting one for me. It was actually a good overall league night for me. It wasn't the best for me, but it was still a really great one. But first, before we get into that, I wanted to actually show you guys what happened in the qualifying for this race. Because that's the real one. You actually show the qualifying of what happened. But this would actually have a knock-on effect for me, not for this round, but for round 6. As you guys see here, the guy goes, basically that card there, he just rolls it. And it's a scary thing to see that when you look at footage of that, and it's terrifying. But luckily the guy was okay. It was a terrifying scene. It was a red flex in the middle of our qualifying. There were some people still driving, which was kind of insane. If I knew the magnitude of the crash at the time, that we would have definitely would have slowed down, stopped, and all stuff that's needed. But going into here, you guys aren't here for the quali stuff. I'm glad that guy's okay though, and we're gonna get into this. So interesting situation. I start on pole for all of the rentals, but I just need to be quicker than the guy. The first heavy, and with that you guys are seeing the start of the race. I don't get quite the best start off the grid, so I have to basically just kind of tuck behind Jason here, who you're actually guys, I'm gonna, this battle right here, this is basically a race long battle, and it was quite amazing, and I'm gonna shut up when I get a chance to, but this race was chaotic. It was awesome. It was a fun race. Shout out to Jason. This was a whole lot of fun, and yeah, I'm gonna come back to you guys at the start of round 6 later on in the race, and I'll see you guys back there. So yeah, overall, that was actually one of my best races of the entire season. Not just because of the fact that I beat everybody in the rental heavy, but I won in the entire rental class, if you want to go by overall. But at the end of the day, that doesn't really matter too much. It just felt good under my belt that I had that kind of potential. I mean, granted, I was in a great kart. But it wasn't even the fastest kart on track. There was a guy in the rental heavies that had an even quicker kart. He managed to actually put a faster lap time in than I did. But it was just, I mean, I did have a quick kart, but the guy behind, he had a kart that did like a 65. And that kart had actually more potential to go even faster than that. So it's like, yes, my kart was good, but it definitely was like, you had to have some sort of driver skill into it. And I was really happy with it overall. Now, remember when I was showing you guys the flipped kart earlier in the qualifier for this round? Well, actually, the kart that flipped over was the kart I was supposed to go in for the second round. But what I was hearing was that it was actually a solid kart, and unfortunately, it was broken because of the rollover. But overall, it's not the end of the world for me. Well, they actually ended up putting me, I believe, in another kart. Wasn't sure how I felt in this kart in qualifying, and as you can see as how far back I am, I probably should have stuck to my gut in it, because I thought it was slow, but it felt good in the corner, so I was thinking, maybe I could do something with this, but maybe I should have swapped out parts. You win some, you lose some, it's not the end of the world, and in this one, I don't think it would have mattered anyway what kart I had in this scenario, because I qualified near the bottom of everybody, so I just had to kind of... I was going into this one thinking, right, is this damage limitation? And I didn't quite do such a good job at that because later on I did spin in the race and it wasn't the best scenario for me. It was kind of a stupid moment where it was like there was four going into one corner and I think one or two of us were going to be spinning around if they weren't careful. Unfortunately, one of them was me. So yeah, that's racing. Luckily, you could drop a couple rounds and it wouldn't really matter too much, but still, it's not too bad at all. And yep, I'll hit you guys at the end of this race in a little bit. Alright, so overall, not my best race, but yeah, it definitely could have been worse. It was basically damage limitation, and yeah, nothing too bad. It wasn't the worst thing in the world, but it could have definitely could have been way better. But yeah, it was definitely a time for me to kind of just... I deserved to kind of be in the mid-pack or lower pack in that one. That actually got me 6th place in that race, which means I would actually get 8 points in that final race. But that's not the end of the world for me, because even with that horrible result, I actually now finish with 33 points ahead of the next driver in the set championship, which that's a very dominant, actually, gap, when you think about it. But you gotta keep in mind there are gonna be 4 dropped rounds throughout the entire championship. There's a 2 zeros that he has will just be dropped, and I have 19 points that'll be dropped. So if you drop my 19, I believe it'll be 30, it'll be a 14 point gap, so a whole win ahead. So it's not exactly I'm a whole like entire round ahead of Alejandro Garcia, while Alex Danigan is definitely not too far behind. I think he's actually 1 point, so he's like 13 points back in this scenario as well. So definitely interesting one. It's gonna be interesting going into the next 2/3 of the championship, and it's gonna be definitely a fun one. I hope you guys did enjoy this one. Feel free to leave a like if you guys enjoyed. If you didn't, you guys know what to do. And if you want to see more of this, feel free to subscribe and all that good stuff. You guys know how to do YouTube. You guys know the drill. And thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys did enjoy.